What's going on, guys? It's Nicole Chandel here. Welcome back to my channel. And as you can see from today's title, we are talking about life update, where I've been, what's going on, why we're still doing YouTube, all that. So if you're new here, once again, my name is Nicole Chandel and I do videos on healthy intentional living, and that is just living your healthy life with intention. So if you like the vibe, please subscribe. I just rhymed and I didn't even plan that. Didn't even plan that rhyme. I filmed in a little while. That's not true. I filmed and I haven't posted. I have been going through a few life changes. That's the best way I can put it. I'm going to just do some light makeup. Anyway, so just a few life changes. Basically, I don't want to call it a depression phase, but I just feel like I was just really sad. I was really sad for the whole month of April. Well, it's still April now. Today's April 24th, but I really haven't felt myself in a few weeks, and I think I figured out why. Because this week is a new week. Today's Monday, and my schedule is kind of really different this week because my parents are away on vacation, so my mom watches my nephew, so now I have to watch my nephew on my days off. So that means I'm more confined to the house, and so that means I can get some things done that I've been lacking on and just pretty much disregarding, just like not caring about. So I can do those things, get back to basically get back on track. That is what I'm going to use this week to do. I'm actually going to film a week in my life. I already started filming it. And so this video, like I said, is just kind of explaining the downward spiral that I've been in. Just a spiral. So it started about a month ago, maybe a month and a half ago, when I was trying to do some just research on budgeting and like how to get my money life together. Trying to get my finances together and all that. And it has just spiraled into, I am currently in a broke phase of my life. Just financially not in a good spot. I still have student loans is what it boils down to. And I have one credit card. I'm in debt, I think my student loans are about $27,000, and then right now my credit card is a little over $1,500, so we'll just say $2,000 there, so about $28,000. However, when I started feeling like this, it was more than that. About $32,000. I think I wrote it down. $32,000 or $33,000. Because I had like more credit cards and stuff like that. So, I mean, we're going in the right direction, but yeah, babe. No, it's Auntie. What do you want more of? So, basically, I was doing research on the cash stuffing method. And if you are subscribers to my channel, I talked about this in like my last two resets, like trying to get my finances together. Like, how can I look at my money and just pay attention to it? So I started doing a budget. I started like really like breaking down my paychecks and breaking down my money, started doing cash stuffing, like really trying to just get a hold of my finances. And I did that and started doing that research. It really just exposed a lot of things about like my finances that I need to get a hold of. And then like the bottom line is I don't make enough money to be able to live. And granted, I live with my parents. And I live with my parents, which is a great blessing right now because I can't afford to live on my own. I have the opportunity to not pay right now. So that's amazing. But to know that I'm still failing, like to know that I'm still behind and I don't have this one big expense is like it was a huge eye opener to me. And I never thought about it that way. Even with like my car, like my dad's been amazing. Like he just got a new car. So like he gave me his old car and like traded in my car, which I did have a small payment left on. So like all that is great because that's really worked out in my favor, but I'm still in the hole. I'm still negative. I'm still in debt. So even after doing all that like research and like really breaking it down and like trying to figure it out, and then still seeing that, oh bro, you still in trouble, like we can't get it together, and that was after like a couple of weeks. So and like I said, this was about a month and a half, like to almost 2 months ago. So like I said, it's April now, so like March, I was like realizing that I just can't do it. I can't do it. And that really like really sent me downhill, like just not in a good headspace. Every week I'm obsessing about it. So then I started watching Dave Ramsey and like listening to his podcast and like basically just like soaking up as much information as I could. How can I get out of debt? Like, how can I get out of this hole? How can I get to a better space? So all in all, like through all that, it was like, okay, you need to, I need to make more money. That's really what it boils down to. Like, I just don't make enough money. So now I had to figure that out. And that just, I know my personality, it is like this. Like I kind of have an obsessive personality where I get into something or like realize something or whatever, and like I just go ham. So like I said, I realized, okay, like I'm in debt and I need to do something about it. I started trying to research jobs. What jobs can I apply to? Like, and I have a full-time job, like I'm a single parent. Like most of the time I'm taking care of my kids. Like other than that, my parents are helping me, my sister's helping me, but I have to take care of them, I have to feed them, I have to clothe them, all that. So like it just really started to build up. On top of that, like I am in a new relationship. So then it was like trying to balance my life and my anxiety and my negativity with my new relationship. And I mean, the relationship's going great. I am not doing great. Like me individually, I'm not doing great. And I had to come to terms with myself and be like, okay, Nicole, you're not doing good. You're not doing any of the things that make you happy, like decluttering, organizing, planning. You're not doing these things. And I was not doing them. Like I did my last monthly reset and I was just so riddled with anxiety and just upsetness that I like literally half did it. Like I just half did it. And I talked about it in that video actually, like how I was like feeling just down and like not there and like just feeling like I couldn't deal. So yeah, and all of this is because of finances, and it's all of this because of like making money and like not being able to make money. And it's just like, it's crazy. It really is crazy. Like just to think, like I never really thought I was like I was that person, but it's just the right now it's like the bare minimum things. Like do I like, if my kid, you know, needs something, can I buy it? Well, no, like I literally have to budget it into my next paycheck because I'm living paycheck to paycheck. Like that's a problem. Like that's a whole problem. Like, do I have an emergency fund? At the time, no. If an emergency happened, I was in trouble, or trying to charge it on my credit card, which at the time was maxed out, like at $2,500. Like, come on. Like, no, failing. And like, I don't know. Like I said, I never thought I was that person that if one aspect of my life was like not doing good, that it would affect everything. But I feel like money is one of those things, unfortunately, that affects your whole life. It affects everything that you do, like where you go on vacation, what you're eating, if you could buy clothes that week, if you can buy something nice for yourself that week. Like it's all wrapped up together with money, like, you know. And because like, for example, take a relationship. You don't have to be in a relationship to be happy, to live your life every day, to go to the places you want and do the things you want to do, which, you know, being single really taught me that. Like, it taught me how to be with myself. It taught me how to say, okay, I want to go out to eat. You can go to a restaurant by yourself. You know, granted, I'm probably going in the middle of the day during lunchtime, but I'll still go by myself, you know, to the movies. I'll still go by myself, all that. But now it's like money. I don't have the money to do these things. I don't have the money to go out to eat. I don't have the money to go to the movies. I don't have the money to buy shoes if I need shoes. To buy anything really outside of food at this point. So, you know, I felt like that was like the real, just the real turning point for me when I realized just how bad it was. So that was like the beginning of April, where I came to a point where I was like, okay, I have to do something. So like I said, I started really researching, looking into the Dave Ramsey plan and getting as much knowledge as I could about it and learning as much as I could every single day, all while still being a mom, all while still going to work, all while still dating and all that. And it was just, Like I wasn't in a bad space. I don't say I was in a bad space, like to the point that everyone was noticing, but when I was by myself in, you know, once I got away from everyone else, that is when I would notice it. Cause like I said, I wasn't even doing the things that I knew I needed to do to function. Like I was doing terrible, just terrible. So anyway, so then about halfway through the month, of April, I noticed this flyer at my gym, and it was basically a job fair at the gym. And I was like, huh, I wonder if I can do this. Like, I really need more income. Like I do, bottom line, I cannot live life with on this income that I have at this point. Like, everybody knows how much gas costs, everybody knows how much groceries cost right now. Like, I just can't do it. You know, yeah, you may asking about my kids and my kids' father with child support and all that. And that was also another big turning point in the situation. Basically, he got hurt at work and he is not able to work right now. So right now we're just out here winging it on my income, and my income, you know, isn't that great. I mean, it's not bad. It's not terrible, but it's not at a point where I can sustain three people. It's just not there. So here comes Toby Todd. What's up? How you doing?
Good.
What you looking for?
Can I watch one of my emotes downstairs?
Like on the TV? I have to turn the TV on for you?
Yeah.
Okay, I can do that. I don't remember where I was, but yeah, basically one income, taking care of three people. Granted, two of them are children, but my children are, you know, getting up there in age. They're 10 and 12. So like they're right now, you know, doing things, activities and stuff like that. And so it's like, now I have to make this crucial decision. I can't even hold up the activities anymore. Like I can't, you know, continue on with that. Like it's either going further in debt or taking care of the problem. And so in April, like in the middle of April, I was just like, no, I'm not going further in debt. Like, I have to figure this out. I have to figure out something. How can I do this? Like, how can I just get better and do this? So that's what I decided to do. Oh, that's what I was talking about. The job fair at my gym. Job fair. That's the best way to basically, that open interviews is what they had. So I was like, I seen it one week and I was like, okay, like maybe I can do this. You know, I had to figure out like what times I can do it. Cause like I said, I do have a full-time job. How can I do it? You know? So I figured out like, if I have certain hours at my full-time job, you know, like in the afternoon, evening, then I can do the gym job in the morning. So I was like, I'm gonna go for it. And I applied and I got a second job. Ooh, yeah, so terrifying, of course. And my parents hated the idea, of course, because they're like, you're never gonna have time with your children. You're never gonna be able to do, you know, do the things that you're doing now with them. Like, how are you gonna do this? Like, you're already stretched in, you're already this, you're already that. And my thing is, I'm trying to take this little ponytail out here. I got my hair done and she tied it with a string, I think. The problem is I don't know where the end is and I don't know where the beginning is. Oh wait, there it goes. There goes that. Let's get this string up out of here. So, yeah. Ugh. I mean, I liked the style, but I'm happy to have my hair done now. All those things are true. Like, you know, I just had to tell my parents, like, at the end of the day, if I am in debt, I cannot take care of my children properly anyway. Like, we'll just be on the struggle for more and more years to come. If I don't stop right now and fix this debt situation, if I don't stop right now and throw everything I have at the debt and try and eliminate it in a year to maybe 2 years, like I really wanna do it in a year, to eliminate it in a year versus as ignoring it and then being stuck and in a bad situation for 5 years. This is a trade-off that I will take every single time to be able to get it done in a short amount of time. So that is really what drove me to sacrifice this time, energy, space, all that to get a second job. I just have to get out of debt. And it's just, and I realized like this is where the anxiety came from. The desire to get out as fast as I can, the desire to run, push, shove everything out of my way to do so. So I had to revamp my budget. I had to take things out of my budget. I had to change, like basically I traded my subscriptions for my self-care, like getting my hair done. Okay, eliminate two or three subscriptions so I can get my hair done. Getting my nails done. Okay, eliminate another 2-3 subscriptions to get my nails done. Like these are the sacrifices that I've decided to make so I can make it through this debt. And that's like just the biggest thing that I'm trying to do right now. The biggest like angst in me was trying to get to a point where I'm like, okay, like, is this possible? Can I do this? And so taking on a second job and like having the possibility of more income, it really allowed me to exhale. I was trying side hustles, trying YouTube, trying blogging, a virtual assistant, everything like that, like trying to make something out of nothing. And it just wasn't working for me. I know it works for a lot of people, like entrepreneurship and like picking up something and like running with it and making it your own and making income from it. Like it works for a lot of people, especially now in the, you know, 2023, like the side hustle gig is a thing, you know, even DoorDash, Instacart, all that. I could not grasp it. It was like trying to like get something with your nails. Like I can't pick it up. Like I just couldn't grasp it to the point of feeling secure about it. That like, okay, this is what I can do. And now, so that's why I had to find something else. I had to find something else and I had to search till I found that. So hopefully, I haven't even started the job yet. I'm still in the process of like the application and like turning in all my papers and stuff like that. And then of course I have my work. I was feeling a little anxious about my actual work because I am committed to this job, like it's my career, but I need to get past this point and just, you know, so going to them and talking to them and letting them know like, this is where I'm at. And I can't do anything. And it's just like, I feel like sometimes it's hard to like, and it's hard, but it's not like really just showing someone else, you know, first of all, like not everybody's life is going perfectly and in the way, you know, in easy, you know what I'm saying? So to say that, oh, this is the salary I give to someone else and that they can do it and they can make it on that salary. But why can't you? Well, we're not in the same situation. We don't have the same circumstances. So, you know, just having to sit down with my current job and like just talk to them about that. That was hard. But I think we're gonna make it work and I'm really just praying and hoping for the best. So Yeah, that's kind of where I'm at and where I've been. And where I'm going is I'm just gonna be working a lot. I don't know what is gonna happen to my YouTube channel. Like I just went through this whole couple weeks of like barely posting because of anxiety, and now I'm gonna go through this starting a new job, having less time situation. So I don't know what it's gonna look like, but I do really enjoy posting on my YouTube channel. I enjoy the community that we have created, you and I, you watching my videos, commenting, being here for me, encouraging. I put out a couple of polls, and like you guys gave me great encouragement on things I can do to try and make more income, or things I can do to eliminate my debt and stuff like that. So I really appreciate that, as well as my 12-week year like being focused, and this is part of it, like finding a way to pay down my debt, like being in a good place, in a good headspace. Like this is part of it, and I really have to just get to a good spot. And so I just want to say thank you to you, viewer, for being here, for watching my videos, and just being that encouragement on all the videos, for commenting and all that. So just thank you. This is not the end. This is just a new chapter, a new beginning. So anyway, this is the end of the video. Thank you for watching. If you want to continue on this journey with me and watch this whole thing play out, make sure you subscribe to my channel. I'll have more videos showing you what's going on. I'm still in the gym. I'm still working out. He sneezed. He wasn't calling you.
What's that sound?
Uncle Nick was sneezing.
Uncle Nick, Tobias.
He did not say Tobias. Anyway, thanks for watching this video, guys, and I'll see you in my next one. Bye.